हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे।
नमस्ते जी, नमस्ते। वेलकम टू कोर्ट रूम। सो लेट अस टेक अ लुक एट जजमेंट्स फ्रॉम 2021, primarily for the perspective of examination preparation. So any law entrance, LLB, LLM, judiciary prelims. But judiciary prelims mein I haven't included judgments from the CRPC, which are extremely crucial to track for any judiciary prelim exam. So hum kya kaam karenge? We'll do a dedicated lecture later just on CRPC judgments. But this is primarily should be helpful for LLB and LLM, and I've filtered out only the relevant bits from the voluminous amount of judgments that Supreme Court issued. First and foremost, Rajiv Suri versus DD and others, in which the Supreme Court upheld the validity of the Central Vista project. However, Justice Khanna dissented. One more Justice Khanna dissented once upon a time, ADM Jabalpur mein. Unki kitab ka naam, Neither Roses Nor Thorns. This is how questions are connected. All right. Secondly, this PDF is free for download. The link to it is in the description. So this PDF also contains a lot, many more judgments. I'll just show you before we proceed ahead with the discussion. Last year also, we had issued a similar one. So this contains prior judgments prior to the ones in 2021, jin pe thoda decision awaited tha, un pe decision aa gaye hain. Purane most important ones you will find in this PDF. It's free to download, but let us discuss all the relevant bits. So Manish Kumar versus Union of India, the Supreme Court upheld section 3, 4 and 10 of the IBC Amendment Act 2010, primarily for LLM purposes. I'm not getting into details of these judgments because I'm primarily focusing this lecture on a prelims sort of an entrance preparation. So Bigger Foundation versus Justice K.S. Puttaswamy, this was the review petition were dismissed. And these review petitions were challenging the judgment in the Aadhaar case. So that is Justice K.S. Puttaswamy versus Union of India. In that judgment also, Justice Chandrachud had dissented. While dismissing these review petitions, Justice D.Y. Chandrachud has again dissented. So, and Shabriwala case mein who dissented? Justice Indu Malhotra. So these dissents are, well, very frequent MCQs in any law entrance exam that you take. Union of India versus K.A. Najib, in which the Supreme Court held that violation of fundamental right to speedy trial is a ground to grant bail under UAPA 1967. Violation of fundamental right to speedy trial. Now, fundamental right to speedy trial is not explicitly mentioned in the Constitution, so there has to be a case law. Which case law is it? Husainara Khatun versus State of Bihar, a very classic question in which we have almost turned 39A, or rather taken most of it, and yeah, aapka jo Justice Venkatachaya commission bhi hui thi, National Commission to Review the Working of the Constitution, they had also recommended moving 39A to Part 3 because a myriad of judgments have declared it to be a fundamental right, that right to free legal aid and right to speedy trial is a fundamental right. So now they have declared that violation of fundamental rights to speedy trial is a ground to grant bail under the notorious UAPA. Vikas Kumar versus UPSC, primarily this is again LLM level stuff. If you will be taking the CLAT LLM in 2022, I highly advise you to go through this judgment once. In this case law, V. Surendra Mohan versus State of Tamil Nadu ka jo Supreme Court pe prior decision hai, it was criticized and it was held that this is not a binding precedent. So in this case law, in Surendra Mohan's case, limit of 50% that a judicial officer should have 50% ability to have visual and hearing so that he can administer justice better. So in this case, this was held that it was a legitimate restriction in Surendra Mohan's case. However, now Supreme Court in Vikas Kumar versus UPSC, because this is primarily a candidate who is seeking a scribe in the UPSC examination. So Supreme Court has now held, well, this is not a binding precedent, Surendra Mohan, and this is not for LLB entrance, is way beyond the purview of LLB entrance. So not a legally binding precedent. After Right of Persons with Disabilities Act 2016 came in, the Supreme Court said, well, that the judges didn't take full due consideration to the provisions of this act. Now, since Right of Persons with Disabilities Act 2016, that is one MCQ, ki year kaun sa tha? International Day of Persons with Disability celebrated when? Now, this becomes an important day connected with static GK, and that is how you think what the examiner is going to ask you, and you stay one step ahead in an examination. Now, if you open the act And in the opening lines, it says, an act to give effect to the United Nations Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities. So they can ask you which year was this convention in. Since India ratified this convention, disabilities, and this we adopted on the 13th day of December 2006. Don't be surprised if this pops up. So Surendra Mohan's decision was criticized in this, Vikas Kumar versus UPSC, and said that 2016 Act was not taken into consideration, and principle of reasonable accommodation was discussed. Again, extremely, extremely crucial from the point of view of a LLM entrance. So the principle of reasonable accommodation, it captures the positive obligation of the state and private parties to provide additional support to persons with disabilities to facilitate their full and effective participation in society. Don't be surprised if they ask you, what do you mean by principle of reasonable accommodation? Again, LLM only. And isse ek aur connected aata hai, wo question, very, very standard question now. Principle of transformative jurisprudence, if I'm not mistaken, of Tej Singh Johar ke andar use hua tha. Kaniz Fatima versus Commissioner of Police, in which, so this is the review petition of Amit Sahni versus Commissioner of Police, and the review petition was dismissed. So the Shaheen Bagh judgment ke andar, in Amit Sahni case, Supreme Court had observed that right to peaceful protest against legislation exists, but the demonstrations expressing dissent have to be in designated places alone. So right to protest cannot be anytime and anywhere. That is what in this review, dismissal of the review petition has been held, that there may be some spontaneous protest, but in case of prolonged dissent or protest, there cannot be continued occupation of public place affecting rights of others. This wasn't followed in the case of the aapke jo farmer bhai behan jo hamare baithe hue the on Singhu border, rather at Singhu border. So wahan pe, because the situation was quite volatile, if the Supreme Court had come out, you know, following this precedent and ordered them to evacuate that space, and let us say ordered them to move to some protest ground, it would have really, really deteriorated the situation. And this is not merely a court of law, it is also a court of justice. And you know, the Supreme Court generally doesn't give out a decision while not taking into consideration the social impact that the judgment will have. And re matters of great public importance touching upon the independence of judiciary. This is an order, not a judgment. So the suo motu proceedings were closed. Panel was headed by Justice A.M. Patnaik. This is related to Justice Gogoi's sexual harassment allegation on Justice Gogoi, and the sexual harassment allegations that were put out on him. And Justice A.M. Patnaik's panel has said that a conspiracy cannot be ruled out, because many folks were really happy with the way Justice Gogoi, ex-CJ Justice Gogoi, proceeded ahead with the Assam NRC case. And he has come out with the book Justice for the Judge. I think this is a 99% sure shot question that will show up in your exams, and there will related Maximus Nemo Judex in Causa Sua, that is, no one should be a judge in his own case. So this was a criticism back in the day when he was sitting in an inquiry panel that was formed against him only. I mean, who will judge and who will pass an order against themselves? So this is a related maxim. So all ancillary details are there. This document doesn't contain three judgments, I think I've forgotten to mention, but I'll tell you after we've finished off the list. So Parna Bhatt versus State of MP is Rakhi for bail order set aside. So yahan pe set of guidelines was issued with courts dealing with sexual crimes, and courts were warned not to give in to patriarchal notions and stereotypical notions about women, कि जी वो जिसके साथ आपने बदतमीजी करी उससे आप राखी बंधवाएं तो ही हम आपको बेल देंगे. सो मध्य प्रदेश हाई कोर्ट्स ऑर्डर वॉज सेट असाइड. सो दे कैन आस्क यू एंड विच केस लॉ वॉज अ सेट ऑफ गाइडलाइंस इशूड फॉर कोर्ट्स डीलिंग विद सेक्शुअल क्राइम्स. देयर वॉज अनदर सेट ऑफ गाइडलाइंस, दैट इज व्हाट आई हैव फॉरगॉटन टू मेंशन दिस लिस्ट इज, देयर वॉज अनदर सेट ऑफ गाइडलाइंस, क्रिमिनल प्रैक्टिस गाइडलाइंस, जो कि हाई कोर्ट्स को इशू करी गई थी. एंड Kirti versus Oriental Insurance Company was about that the household work has economic value, and Article 224A, but uske upar maine already discussion kari hui hai is channel pe. Association for Democratic Reforms of the Union of India, writ petition 880 of 2017. Why have I given you the citation of this very case law? Because ADR puts in a lot of cases, lot of petitions, and a lot of judgments are there. So not to get confused, SC refused stay of electoral bonds. This was prior to West Bengal elections. They wanted anonymous electoral bonds to be set aside, which the Supreme Court refused to. Muhammad Salimullah versus Union of India, that right not to be deported is ancillary to a fundamental right only available only to Indian citizens. So Article 19 is available only to Indian citizens. Now this has popped up this year. You can think of a question that which of the following fundamental rights is not available to foreigners. So that is a very, very standard question that you can pull out by looking from Article 14 and go till 32 and see which of the rights, jiske andar any person likha hai, that means foreigners are included and citizens only. So only citizens. So Article 19 is available only to citizens. And 19 clause 1 sub clause E is available only to citizen. And right not to deported is a right ancillary to this right. So deportation of Rohingya settled in Jammu. The Supreme Court said, well, since you are not a citizen to begin with, how do we exactly give you this right? Because Article 19 is limited to citizens only. Then we go to encroachment of state legislature upon the domain of parliament. That's the main heading. This is Forum for People's Collective Efforts versus State of West Bengal. The Supreme Court explained the concept of repugnancy available in Article 254, if I'm not mistaken, Part 11, relation between the Union and the states, related to Schedule 7, that the Union law prevails over the state law. West Bengal Housing Industry Regulation Act 2017, well, it was struck down, and the Supreme Court used its powers to do complete justice under 142. The previous sanctions, licenses, registrations that were given under this act will continue to have effect. You can say doctrine of prospective overruling as propounded in Golaknath. Alright, so this is done. This we have already discussed time and again, and in previous lectures I've already discussed this. Questions have already popped up in 2021 already. I think DUL will be asked this, CLAT, LLM asked this, everyone asked this. So not really, they won't be really repeating any questions in the 2022 examinations. Perhaps they come out with newer questions, so just think about it. But primarily, what one question that they have not asked in 2021 examinations is about the 105th constitutional amendment, that is also related to this case. And how is it related? Already explained in a lecture. I'll link everything in the iCard. Dr. Jayashree Lakshman Rao Patil was the chief minister, also known as the Maharashtra Kota case or Maharashtra reservation case. So primarily, I won't go into the judgment details because we've discussed this time and again over the last 1 year. But the 102nd constitutional amendment was, the Supreme Court had held that this abrogated the state's powers to determine and identify SEBCs. So, and the power now exclusively belongs to the president after the 102nd constitutional amendment. So the parliament did not agree. So the parliament has brought in the 105th constitutional amendment. I'll leave the link to the lecture of the reasoning behind 105th CA. Please watch that. It covers out each and every MCQ that the examiner can possibly ever ask from you, and also gives you pointers for subjective type answers. Election Commission of India versus MR Vijay Bhaskar, is in which basically right before the second wave, we are now standing right at the arrival of the third wave. Right before, at the onset of the third wave, you can use a better word than arrival. The Election Commission, because back then West Bengal wagera mein rally wagera ho rahi thi, so Madras High Court had orally observed that the Election Commission of India should be booked for murder. So ECI went to the Supreme Court to expunge those oral remarks, and the question that arose on which the Supreme Court decided that the media is free to report the oral observation and discussions, and that is a part of Article 19, Clause 1, Subclause A. Alright. So case law becomes important because is saal ye pucha nahi gaya hai, or booked for murder. ECI wanted to expunge this remark. Vinod Dua has passed away. May God give peace to his soul and gati ahead for higher rebirths. Vinod Dua versus Union of India. The sedition case was squashed against him. And Kedarnath Singh versus State of Bihar 1962 was referred to, and this is a cardinal judgment for the LLM folks. Please refer to this judgment, can be asked. Madras Bar Association versus Union of India, in which the tribunal reforms ordinance was struck down, and then government passed an act. And then the Supreme Court lashed out at the government, but usse hota hai kya? Kyunki government wale bhi dheet hain, sab log apna apni basically game khelte rehte hain. So the tribunal reforms ordinance was struck down. I think they wanted टेन्योर के ऊपर झगड़ा चल रहा है इनका, बट अभी भी चल ही रहा है. यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया वर्सेज राजेंद्र शाह एंड अदर्स, दिस हैज टू शो अप बिकॉज दिस डिड नॉट शो अप मोस्टली ऑन इन ऑल क्वेश्चन पेपर्स दैट आई सॉ. दिस डिड नॉट मोस्टली शो अप समवेयर इन बिट्स एंड पीसेस इट डिड शो अप बट नॉट मेजरली. सो टाइगर अभी जिंदा है फॉर नेक्स्ट ईयर इन 2022. दिस यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया वर्सेज राजेंद्र शाह एंड अदर्स अगेन ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड ईच एंड एवरीथिंग दैट द एग्जामिनर कैन पॉसिबली आस्क्ड. ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड इट ऑन द चैनल. आई विल जस्ट पॉइंट दैट वीडियो आउट टू यू एज वेल. पार्ट 9B हैज बीन स्ट्रक डाउन which was inserted by the 97th Constitutional Amendment Act of 2011, in which the reasoning was given that Article 368 Clause 2 was not complied with. Article 368 belongs to Part 20 of the Constitution. Justice Joseph said, well, doctrine of severability is not applicable. Now, what do I mean by this? So, the 97th Amendment did a lot many more things. It introduced the fundamental right to form cooperative societies. It introduced quite a lot in addition to introducing Part 9B. So two judges of the three judge bench, two judges said we are only going to be striking down Part 9B. Justice Joseph said strike down the entire amendment because it did not comply with 368 Clause 2, because this for the government to have passed such an amendment, they needed ratification by one half of the state legislatures as provided in Article 368. And this is the lecture that you must watch. This was what, 5 months ago, right? Doesn't have many views as usual, but any which way. Right to shelter does not mean right to government accommodation. This is Union of India versus Onkar Nath Dhar. So the Punjab and Haryana High Court had passed this this judgment. They appealed. Basically, a retired intelligent bureau officer doesn't get right to government accommodation. So they were argue that this is my fundamental right under right to shelter under Article 21. The Supreme Court said, well, that's not a valid argument. NGD has suo motu jurisdiction. So this is the case law in Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai versus Ankita Sinha. NGD has power to take cognizance of matters on the basis of letters, representations and media reports. Alright. Right to apply for bail is an individual right implicit in Article 14, 19 and 21, also known as the Golden Triangle of the Constitution. This is High Court of Judicature for Rajasthan versus State of Rajasthan and another, in which basically the High Court, a single judge directed the registry not to put up bail matters because I think it was some lockdown related issue. So well, it was appealed against. Now, two lectures that we already done, because this is, you know what, 19, not really any significant development that you can say that happened much in 2021, since it was clouded by the COVID second round and now almost the third wave. These were the lectures that we had posted. It was 9 months ago, 8 months ago, and we had discussed all of these lists. Jiskinder, I have pointed out the links to the judgments, what is happening in the case laws, and I've given you some prior, jo pehle ki bhi, jaise like Ram Mandir case ka jo naam hai, exception was read down from Section 375 IPC Independent Thought. Then Fahima Shireen, right to access internet is a fundamental right. So a lot of things are there in this entire document. I've attached my own notes used to create this lecture. All right, so you can download it from the link down below. I think Navtej Singh Johar is there, Joseph Shine is there, Shafin Jahan, Puttaswamy is there. Most of the, I think 70-80% jo bhi Supreme Court ke upar se log jo question puchne wale hain aapse, should be there in this document. Shyam Narayan Choksi is there, Emmanuel is there, everything is there. Link to everything, I think 2021 likha hua hai, khair wo purane document ki list. Any which way. So all of this is there in the description. Wishing you a very, very happy new year. Hopefully this lecture has been of help to you. All right. And well, wishing you good solid preparation for your examinations, and now see you in the new year. Take care, bye.